Hi there, handbaggers, and welcome to the Duck's Nest. This is the Military Mom, and in this video, I'm going to update you all on the repair process on my Hammitt Montana reversible crossbody. So just so you know, I am actually sitting on the floor in the bathroom because I'm still playing with the lighting, and so far, I think this is the most direct lighting I've been able to achieve in the new Duck's Nest. So also, just in case these make an appearance, I am wearing my booties because it has been very chilly here where I am in Florida. It's actually been in the 40s all day, which is probably some kind of record. But yeah, I have my booties on. All right, so a little backstory. Maybe November, December last year, I pulled out this bag and I hadn't carried it in a long while. And in the process of carrying it, the rings disengaged from the bag. And when I say rings, I'll show you and you'll know what I mean in a few minutes. So the rings disengaged from the bag. I went onto the Hammitt website because Hammitt has a lifetime guarantee on workmanship and materials. The process seemed easy. They said, just take pictures, email it to us, and we'll take it from there, which is exactly what I did and exactly what Hammitt did. I received a confirmation email really quickly. They asked for my mailing information. They emailed me a UPS prepaid envelope. So all I had to do was take that prepaid label. I took the label to the UPS store and really asked the representative to just put it in one of those big plastic mailing envelopes. Dropped it off and that was it. Hammitt confirmed receipt and told me it would take 4 to 6 weeks. That was on January 12th. Today is February 2nd. So what is that? Roughly, we're going to call it 3 weeks, right? From the time they received the bag through repair to me receiving the bag back. So we are now going to take a look at the repaired bag. And this is the envelope that they, not the envelope, it's a card. This is the card that they sent me. So this is how it was mailed back. No weather protection, but it was in the, I think this is my original dust bag. And let me move this out of the way. These are really nice dust bags. They're very soft, not coarse like the Dooney and Burke dust bags. They're not as heavyweight as the Coach 1941 dust bags, however, but pretty nice. I love the fact that they're black. And look at this. There is a pocket on the back. So if you want to place your bag charm there, there's a nice little place for it. All right, so this is the bag, and I can tell you right off the bat, they should have repaired that. I sent them pictures of that. They didn't repair it, but let me go ahead and take a look at the hardware. I'm not real concerned with that, and I'll tell you why in a minute. So it looks like they replaced these rings, because these look much newer than the rings that I sent them. And then I never had any issues with these flat rivets. This is the crossbody strap, which has all types of flat rivets on both sides. So as I said, this bag is reversible. This is the bag on the taupe side. And then this is the bag on what I call the saddle colored side. Oh shoot, hold on. Right? So if you're not familiar with this bag, it has four pockets. There's a pocket here, which is accessible regardless of whichever side it's on. There's the Hammitt debossed logo. And look at this lining. It's like a snakeskin, but it's a textile. So this pocket goes to about there. And on the taupe side, you have access to this cell phone pocket, which is nice. And then there's the one pocket. Here's the other pocket, which has the credit card slot. And also Hammitt debossed there. And I can tell you all, I have handled a lot of leather in my handbagging days, but I have never felt anything as supple as Hammitt leather. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Which is why I splurged and bought this bag. The reason that I'm not real concerned about this, even though I asked them to repair it, is when the bag is on the taupe side, this is against your body, so you really can't see that. And then when it's on the saddle side, that is underneath the flap, you can't see it at all. But I would have liked it if they had repaired that, because then my bag would have been so gorgeous. Here's a look at the graining and the stitching. And then the hardware brushed gold, so pretty. And then the strap on the saddle side, and then the crossbody strap on the taupe side. And then here is the lobster claw to attach it to these rings. So overall, I was very happy with the process. Very little interaction or frustration on my part, because once I dropped it off at UPS, Hammitt kept in contact with me. I didn't have to follow up or anything. Unlike the coach horror stories I've heard recently. So there's the interior of the gusset. And regardless of which side you carry the bag on, you can access all the pockets except this cell phone pocket if it's on the saddle side. All right, so yes, I was very happy with the process, except like I said, that one spot that Hammitt didn't fix. But if you do not own a Hammitt bag and this has intrigued you, you may want to take a look. This taupe side is smooth for the most part. And then the saddle side is very pebbled. So it's like two handbags in one. But yeah, very nice carry. Okay, that I think wraps it up. Hammitt lifetime guarantee. Anything goes wrong, they take care of it. All you have to do is take it to UPS and drop it off. I hope this has been helpful. And thank you so much for dropping by the Duck's Nest. And as always, happy carrying.